Yeah, what up guys, it's TK Techie, and today we'll be unboxing the gamepad GameStar G3S. Stay tuned. The features about this gamepad is that it can connect to your PC, Windows PC, your PlayStation 3, and also to your Android device. And one beautiful thing about it is that it uses the Bluetooth 4.0 that is at 2.4 GHz speed. So why don't we just get this opened, and this is the package. Yeah, I got this product for about $39 on Amazon, and if you're in Nigeria also you can get about 13,000 or so. I'll be leaving the links for the Amazon and for Jumia and Konga down below this video, so you can check that out. And why I just really choose this gamepad above every other gamepad is that I can also connect it to my Gavioda. Yeah, I also have a Samsung Gavioda, which I'll be uploading videos on it very soon. So let's just open it. So yeah, this is the gamepad, very portable and nice, really nice. I like the texture. So this is the Bluetooth that I can connect to your PC. Yes, if you want it wireless, you use this Bluetooth here. I think it's Bluetooth 4.0. Then you have a USB cord. There's one for charging. I guess this will be for charging. The shorter one will be for charging, while the longer one is for connecting to the PC or either to your Android if you are to your Android if you want to make use of OTG cable, or you connect it to the PC also. So PC is usually more preferable, just in case you don't want to make use of the wire or wireless. And that's at the outer part. We'll get that aside. And yeah, this is the bracket. We call this bracket. And what this is for major is that, okay, let me just put this aside first. I'll show you what this, why you make use of this. And this is most of the paperwork, there are instructions. And I think when you just get this, you can just scroll about it and read. I know major things you need to know, because it's very important to learn most of the things about the product. So that's all about what's inside. And now, okay, this is the cord, two USB cord and Bluetooth. Get this here. So what this is majorly is for is that you use this to connect through your phone. It's called the bracket. So this is how you get this done. You put the bracket into this like this. Let's see if I can get this focused. Okay. Then you clip it down. It's clipped down like this. So you put your phone here. Let me see. Okay, here is on my phone now. And okay, let me just put this. Don't worry about that. Let me put this here. So you connect your phone here like this. Yeah, in tight it, there's a screw. Wow, because I didn't tight this first, as I'm supposed to do. I'm supposed to make this tight at first. I can see it can't go up or down. Then I connect this to it. So I connect this like this. You can see it hold it firm, but it's still at the other way around. So I'm just trying to lose it a little bit. Then says it will like this. Yes, so it's connected like this. You can see it's very nice. Wow, I didn't set this well. I made it too much, a little bit tight. Okay, that will just be that for that. So it's just for your phone. It's really nice. And yes, for the cord to charge or to connect down to your PC. And this is how you get this done. You plug this the USB cord into the connector here and you get it charged. You can plug this to your charger for the power source, and get that one done itself there. So this is all about the bracket aspect of it. Now let's now talk about the gamepad itself. So what this gamepad is for major is that, like I said, it connects to Bluetooth. It connects through Bluetooth or through wired using the cord, and also you can connect it through your Android, your PC. Oh, did I mention about iOS? Sorry, You can also connect it to your iOS device, either your Apple, laptop or your Apple phone, your iPhone. Connect it also to your PlayStation 3. There's one beautiful thing about this I'd like you guys to see, and that's, yeah, these colorful buttons. Yes, these colorful buttons makes this really, really fun, in the sense that when you're playing a game, let's say somewhere dark, like me, I love playing games where somewhere is dark on my PC, and you know, you would also want to feel that excitement of playing the game. Like your buttons are on and the other aspect of it and your rooms are just dark and you just like play it. It's just really, really nice. The texture also has a premium texture. It's not like an ordinary one cheap pad. So let's now talk about the buttons on the keyboard, or likely the button, I call it the buttons on the gamepad, on the pad itself. So we have the D-pad. This is what we call the D-pad, the direction, the up, the down, side, left, and everything. This is the analog. Then this is the power on button. You on this, if you want to on the device, gamepad, you have to hold this button for like 3 seconds. If you want to on it, you hold it for like 3 seconds. Then you have the select button here, over here. Select button. You have the turbo button. This turbo button is majorly for like vibration of a thing. And like when you're playing like motor racing games, playing like GTA 5, playing like you have God of War on PC. You have Call of Duties. Like when you're shooting, in that aspect itself, like getting that vibrant feeling on the device, on your PC, through your PC or through your phone, if you are playing on the phone, any of your games that support Bluetooth, so you get that vibration itself. But I've only tried it on PC initially, so I know how the vibration feels. I've not tried it on phone, so that's what that toolbar is for. And this is clear. You have the start button, you have the X button, you have the Y button, you have the B and the A. So at this side of the device, you have the L1, L2. I don't know if you are seeing this, I think it's a little bit dark. R1 and R2 is the connector here. Then in case of any let's say about maybe you've done some settings and you don't even know where you've gone to and the rest like that, you can always tick on the reset button, your reset space there. I think there's a selection here. And at the back, let me see if I can get this focused. Yeah, okay. At the back, if you want to connect to an Android device, they said you have to press the A and the home button. Like I said, the home button is this little G with the button inside. So you press the home button alongside with the A button itself. Then for iOS device, that's Y plus O. You can also get this in the paperwork, in the description of the device in the pack. Then to connect as a mouse, you can always press X with the select button. So all these, you see them through, you can always go through their website to get more details about the device. So I feel you should always read the instruction first before you start making use of gamepads like this, which I already know the gamepad is a little bit pricey, or still nice for the price. Yes, I believe it's really, really nice for the price. So now I want to talk about this section of the gamepad, and what we have right here, I want to try and get this focused. So what we have right here, okay, it's focused now. We have the Android logo here, we have the Apple logo here, the mouse, and the X. I think this X is just for an indicator, if I'm right, if I'm not saying something wrong, because it's not, I don't basically know everything about it at once, so the things I know I can really explain on it, but it's always in the description. So like I said, in the Android, to connect to the Android, you press the A, if I'm right here, the A with the home. Okay, so I'll just press the A and this. Now you can see it's at the Android aspect, the Android is indicating. Then for the iOS, it says Y plus home, so that's what I'm supposed to press at first. So it's Y, yeah, then plus home. I'm gonna press this again, you see it's going to change to the iOS. That's the number two. I think it's going to off first. Yes. And press it now down to the second one. That's it. So you connect, if you want to connect to the iOS, that's what you press. And the third one is for through mouse, you can use it as a mouse. Yeah, I think that'll be for the PC. If you want to play on PC, that'll be. Let's not talk about the physical design, but okay, we've talked about the physical design, but let's talk about the power saving itself and long battery life in total. So this device takes there about two to three hours to charge, in the sense that you always use your cord. It's not compulsory to make use of Discord initially. You can always use your device cord, your phone cords, whereby you use to charge your phone. If that's fast charge, you can always use that to charge. But I think it's preferable to make use of this. And I don't know, but I feel it would be better. Then the power usage for it is 18 hours in total. I've not used it. I'm not sure if I've used it up to 18 hours because I don't calculate my gameplay in general. In the sense that I play a lot of games and you don't expect me to put my gameplay in timing or something. But in the description, it says 18 hours in total, and I feel it's up to that on a serious note. Then the battery capacity itself, built-in battery is 600 mAh. As I said, 18 hours in total. So that's all about the review and the unboxing of the Gamepad G3S in total. So let's see if you have any recommendation down below the link, or you'd like me to do like a gameplay video with using this device. Like I said, I use it a lot. I use it for my Gear VR. I'm making videos on that very soon. Just watch out for it. And I use it on my Android device, on my Samsung. I'm using the Samsung Note series, so it works fine on it. And on my PC, also on HP PC, it also works fine on it, because I play a lot of FIFA, PES and other games like that, hardcore games, and it's really, really nice. What I really like is about that vibration, the two ball feature about it. And just stay tuned and give this video a thumbs up if you really like this video, and like you guys to subscribe to my channel to keep taking.